What's up, guys? Jimmy Your Chaos, welcome back, and I wanted to do two things in this video. First of all, I want to say thank you for all the awesome support on the last two videos. It's very refreshing to see all the actual Team Chaos people show up and just kind of show their dedication and remind me of what kind of viewership that I have. Even through all the negative comments and everything that I get from people, there's some truly phenomenal people that follow and have supported me for a long, long time. So truly wanted to say thank you to you guys. And two things. First, I wanted to show off this Jungle Party camo. This was a big deal. This was hyped. I saw a lot of YouTubers do videos on this. I'm late to the party on getting it. I've had it for a day or two. But I was excited to try it on. I'm big about the camos. I love the Sunshine, the Firebrand camo, the Wartorn camo, and there's a couple others that are my favorites right now. But the Jungle Party was supposed to be just this vibrant, cool, electric-feeling camo. Not electric like electricity, just really vibrant. And I put it on, and I was kind of disappointed. You see it on the screen right here. And it's, to me, it's kind of dull. I mean, it's cool, I guess, in a way, but doesn't really live up to the hype that I thought it would when I threw it on a gun. Some camos just pop off the gun. Like the other day, I did a video with the Sunshine camo on the Dingo, and it just looked absolutely immaculate. And I was hoping for that with the Jungle Party, but it didn't work out. But it's still a cool camo, and I wanted you guys to see it if you haven't happened to see it before. And the other thing I want to talk about is the Awakening DLC. We are getting closer. We are now almost to mid-month in January, and at the beginning of February, we are going to get this DLC pack, which we already know. We've seen the four multiplayer maps to a degree. We'll get some more trailers and stuff, I'm sure, leading up to it. And we know that Skyjacked is hijacked, and we're getting a zombie map that looks pretty cool. There's already been a ton of zombie YouTubers that have tied Easter eggs. Just this huge melting pot of history, backstories, Easter eggs being found in old games when it comes to zombies. It's absolutely phenomenal. It's great. It's great for the community. And I look over there at the zombie community, I'm like, wow, that's freaking awesome. Now, here's my question. I don't think it's just going to be zombies. I think Treyarch is going to have something up their sleeve when it comes to multiplayer as well. We couldn't ask for more when it comes to Easter eggs being back in the limelight, or the spotlight, if you will, in Call of Duty. There was a time back through Call of Duty Ghosts and Advanced Warfare, there wasn't much onus put on Easter eggs, from teddy bears to Easter eggs or anything. There was some out there. There was stuff. Don't get me wrong. There's stuff in every game. But it wasn't like back in Modern Warfare 3 and Modern Warfare 2 and just Black Ops and Black Ops 2. They were just all kinds of cool little things that you can enjoy. And Black Ops 3 has just totally brought that back to life, which is huge to me because I'm a huge fan of Easter eggs. Not just Call of Duty, but Easter eggs in general. And I'm really glad they did. I hope that continues into whatever Infinity Ward brings us in 2016, almost 2017. But with that being said, I think there's going to be some secrets. I think the DLC is going to have some stuff that is not talked about, not promoted, or in trailers or anything that we're going to be able to look and find. I cannot wait to scavenge the four multiplayer maps, especially Gauntlet and Skyjack, to see if there's any little nuggets in there that they put out there for us to hunt. I mean, we've seen some just crazy Easter eggs in multiplayer, from the Nuketown zombie Easter eggs, the mannequin, to all the Easter eggs that tie in zombies with multiplayer over on the map Infection. You name it. I mean, there's maps that are linked together with different structures. You can tell they're maps that are close together. There's teddy bears everywhere, all the way through campaign, zombies, and multiplayer. I couldn't be happier. I'm really excited, and I think we're going to be in store for some cool stuff when it comes to multiplayer. I would like to see, in the future, multiplayer developers kind of take a page from the zombie guys. Now, I know the zombies, they have the lore and the history and the storyline, but it'd be cool if somehow multiplayer kind of tapped into that a little bit. I'm not saying it has to be a storyline. Maybe it could be connected more to the campaign. I don't know. I just think it would be cool if there was something we could follow, because those dudes are finding like ciphers and codes and hidden messages and everything. And I guess you can't really do that. Multiplayer is more of on an island. There's not really any backstory to it to a degree. But if somebody could figure that out, I think it would be really, really cool for the community. But I'm excited. I think we're going to get some special stuff. I really do. I think we're going to find some special Easter eggs. I know you guys are going to help hunt once it gets here. And I will be covering Awakening for you guys with every awakening bone in my body. Ha! Anyway, okay. Hope you guys have a great night, and this is the Jungle Party. Jungle Party on the TV here. Not really a big fan of it, but it is what it is. Thank you for all the support, guys, and I'll see you tomorrow. Another round coming up. Don't burn out. Losing C. Brother Gil. Counter UAV. Enemy has Charlie. UAV inbound. And that's how we do it. Get ready for the next round. Enforcer defeated.